Hello and welcome to another how-to video. Today we will be showing you how to get into safe mode in Windows 10. Windows 10 is different than previous versions of Windows as far as getting into safe mode. You can't use F8 during startup. Usually in Windows 10, startup is almost instantaneous, so you wouldn't really have the opportunity to do it anyway. So they had to come up with some different methods in Windows to do that. And so we're going to show you about 5 or 6 different methods to get into Windows 10 safe mode. We're going to start here by going to Settings, that's in your Start menu, then go to Update and Security, Recovery, and then Advanced Startup. Click Restart Now. That'll take you to the Advanced Startup menu. This menu is very useful. It's one of the main ways of getting into safe mode. So if you go to Troubleshoot, Advanced Options, see more recovery options, and Startup Settings. This is Startup Settings menu is the menu that you use to choose safe mode and also what version of safe mode you would like to run. There are different versions if you just want a command prompt or a version that does have networking. There's different options for you. And when you're at the Startup Settings menu for the second time, it'll ask you which version of safe mode do you want. We're just gonna do number 4, which is standard, that's F4, standard safe mode. And now we are in Windows 10 safe mode. Let's go ahead and restart the system. If I restart the system now, it will go into normal Windows. As I mentioned before, the Advanced Startup menu is very useful for getting into safe mode, and there are multiple ways to get to that menu. So if you don't want to go all the way to your settings into security and recovery, you can do right click on the start button, go to the restart button, hold down the shift key, and click restart. And then when the system restarts, it will take you back to that advanced menu, and it will give you the options. Another way of getting to the startup options, if you are on the lock screen, maybe you're not logged in, you can do the exact same thing that we did before. We're not signed in, we'll go down to power. There's the restart button, hold down the shift key again, click restart, we'll say restart anyway. And again, we are back to the advanced startup options menu. Another way of getting to the safe mode for Windows, especially useful if you need to get into safe mode several times, so you don't want it just for one reboot, but maybe you want it for several reboots, you can enable safe mode as the default, essentially, by going into the msconfig. So we're going to want to hit the Windows key plus R, that'll bring up the run menu. You do msconfig, hit enter, that will pull up msconfig, go to the boot tab, and then there is safe mode. And just like with the advanced startup options menu, you do get different versions of safe mode that you can use. The minimal is the normal safe mode. So if we hit apply and okay, it will ask you if you want to restart now. If you want to go to safe mode right now, then you can do so. If you want to do safe mode on your next restart, then you can do exit without restart. But we're going to go ahead and restart now. And this will take us into safe mode. And the difference here is that it will stay in safe mode. So if you want to get back out of safe mode, then you'll want to do the exact same process in safe mode. You'll want to open up msconfig and tell it to boot normally. And we're going to do that here in just a second. Okay, now we are in safe mode, Windows R, msconfig, hit enter, boot. And you can see the option for safe mode is still selected. We unselect that, hit apply, hit okay. And then just like before, if we hit restart, it'll do it right now. And instead of going into safe mode, it'll now go back into normal Windows. Now, all of these methods are good and they work, but you may be screaming at your monitor right now, the only time I ever go into safe mode is when there is a serious problem with my computer. And oftentimes, I cannot get into normal Windows to do all of these things. That's fine. There are still ways to get into the advanced startup menu, even if you can't get into normal Windows. So one of the main ways, and I'll try to demonstrate that for you now, is if you have more than 2 boot failures. So you start up your system and more than twice, it's just not able to do it. That is one way of triggering the system to go into the advanced startup options. So We're going to go ahead and shut down our system, and we're going to simulate a system that can't start up just by turning off the power while the system is turning on. I don't recommend trying this on your own system, but this is just for demonstrative purposes, so that you know that this does work. Okay. So our system is now booting up. You'll want it to go through your post, and you'll want it to start starting up Windows. There we go. Killed power. Turn power back on. Again, killed power while it was turning on. Turn the system on again. And now, because it's failed to boot up twice, it says preparing automatic repair. So the system has detected that in the last two startup attempts, it wasn't able to get into Windows correctly. So you see, it brings us back to this menu again. So you can go to Troubleshoot, Advanced Options, Show More Recovery Options, and then again, your startup options or your startup settings are right there. So that's a way of getting into safe mode if you're just not able to get your system to work at all. So hopefully that was helpful to you. That was five easy ways of getting into Windows 10 safe mode, different than on previous versions of Windows. If you're having trouble with your Windows installation for any reason, or you have another reason of getting to safe mode, hopefully this will help you get there a little bit faster. Join us for some more future how-to videos on PC gaming and using your PC in general to help make you a super user of EVGA products. You have a good one.